looks at that like she looks like she hit somebody.
So he punched you one time?
Yes, he did. He punched me, bam, right in the face.
Was she hitting him at all when
yes.
she was?
Okay. Yes.
You know
she scratched him.
So I don't hit you. Back up.
Are you
my house? Back up.
Are you threatening me?
Yeah, I am.
Here.
No. I'm not going to jail, bro. I didn't do it.
Ser propietario de una vivienda es algo a lo que la mayoría de la gente aspira.
Hey, stay right here.
La idea de formar una familia en tu propio espacio, con libertad para hacer lo que quieres, es muy atractivo, a menos que estés atrapado con un vecino del infierno.
So, what part of your house did she hit?
Right there.
Okay.
En el episodio de hoy conocerás a 7 personas que nunca querrías tener como vecinos. Agrede al hijo del vecino. Comenzamos en Fort Myers, el 10 de julio de 2023, cuando se llamó a agentes del orden para investigar una denuncia de agresión en un complejo de apartamentos. La persona que llamó al 911 alegó que una mujer adulta agredió a su joven vecino. Cuando los agentes llegaron al lugar, el presunto sospechoso estaba fuera esperándolos. Tenía mucho que decir, incluido que no había hecho nada malo, y los agentes rápidamente se enteraron de su mala actitud.
What can I do for you?
Well, I got a few questions. Are you involved in this incident that happened earlier with the kid or whatever getting
no.
pushed around? No.
That kid came to our property, knocking on my mother's door.
So it was your mom who was involved in it?
Yeah, but...
Well, where's your mom at? We'll talk to her.
She's actually not.
No? So that lady yelling right there is not your mom?
I want to talk to her, sir.
So your mom is here?
Yeah, she's here.
So you're lying to me, right?
I'm not lying.
She wasn't lying. I just got here.
Okay, so what's going on between
well,
you and
Well, I was here and that little boy came in my house
when
and put his fist up to me. He went like this, okay? And I'm not going to let no little boy disrespect me. I don't care how old they are.
She,
he came knocking on my
yeah,
door.
Yeah, for no reason.
Right? For no reason.
Leave
knocking
the cigarette
on my door.
There, babe.
La mujer, identificada más tarde como María, intenta montar una defensa alegando que la presunta víctima de agresión destrozó su coche. Ciertamente eso no justificaría ponerle las manos encima a un menor, lo cual ella negó, pero era todo lo que tenía y lo hizo lo mejor que pudo.
Knocking on my door. Look, they vandalized my car.
Yeah.
First they
She's
scratched my car. First they scratched my car. Now they took a piece off of it. I'm putting up enough. Okay?
And then he comes to her door.
And then he comes to my door. And you think I'm not gonna, just because he's a little boy, I'm gonna let him hit me or threaten me?
So you're saying that he walked up these
yeah,
stairs?
Yeah, he walked up these stairs and knocked on my door.
He told me, actually.
Yes, of course.
He told me.
Why would I lie?
Why is he knocking on your door?
Who knows?
Who knows? Because he think he's bad or because he's, I don't know. He knocked on my door. He came up
He told me that, too.
He came up my house.
Okay?
Okay?
Put your hands on the kid out of here?
Huh?
Putting your hands on a kid out here?
No, I didn't put my hands on the kid. He came in my house.
And
inside my house.
He came inside?
Yes.
Because at first you said he was outside the house.
No, he came outside the house, knocked on my door, and he came in my house and started threatening me and talking shit to me. And he's only 14 years old.
He went inside the
house? Yeah. He usually
inside
comes in my house. He's usually a friendly person. My man knows him. My old man knows him. My daughter knows him. You know, but I don't know what's going on. But someone vandalized my car. You want to see where they vandalized my car?
You can see the piece.
Look, they took my piece off of my damn car. They scratched my car. And I'm supposed to live with it. Okay? Like nothing ever happened. Okay? Anything. That little boy came in my house. And his
mom. That's fine. That's
and
fine.
He told
Listen,
me that.
You're going to be detained right now for a second.
Oh, my God.
What?
No, you're not going to be detained me.
Oh,
you're
so
not
you going to touch
me.
Like
you
that.
Don't
I'll
touch me.
You,
you
right
tell
now.
Me why I'm being detained first. B, tell me why I'm being detained.
Oh,
put your hands behind your back.
No, tell me why I'm being detained. No, that. You tell me why I'm being detained.
Call
the lawyers.
Call
a lawyer.
Put your hands behind your back now.
Why
am
I being detained?
Pending further investigation.
For what?
As of right now, you need to do what I'm telling you to do or you're going to get tased.
I'm not doing it. Do what you want to do. Hit me. Hit me.
Turn around.
Tell me why I'm being detained. That kid came to my house. That kid came to my house.
She
told me.
She was being cooperative with you. Why are you detaining her? She was being cooperative with you.
Turn around. Okay, I'm recording.
Dale, golpeame.
Okay, I'm recording.
Throw me on the ground.
Because she was being cooperative.
Because I didn't do nothing wrong.
Really wrong.
Okay?
Estaba demasiado dedicada a su historia y el oficial se vio obligado a devolverla a la realidad con una descarga eléctrica, pero solo por un momento. Luego afirmó que iba a llamar a su abogado y presentar una demanda contra el oficial.
No, ya, espérate. No.
Put your hands behind your back now. Put your hands behind your back now.
I'm calling the cops on
Put your hands behind your back now or you're going to get tased again. Put your hands behind your back now or you're going to get tased again. I'm going to tell you one more time.
I got my hands behind my back.
Both of them. On your stomach now.
Okay.
On your stomach, behind your back.
You got it.
On your stomach, behind your back.
You got it, bud. You, Paulina, you and your friends just my ass.
I hear what she was talking
to. I didn't do nothing wrong.
Why you had to do that?
I don't care. It didn't even hurt.
Video. She was talking to the officer and then he decided.
I'm gonna call the lawyer on him.
That's perfectly
fine. Call his name. What's your name?
She was quiet.
What's your name?
As of right now, you're being placed under arrest for resisting.
I want your name.
You'll get it all in a minute.
I'm recording
her right now. I am.
Stand up.
And then he put his
all the way up.
For no reason.
Don't grab me. Do not f***ing grab me. Do you understand that? It's gonna end real bad for you. No, you're not gonna get anything.
Una vez que ella estaba bajo custodia, el oficial habla con la madre de la víctima para tener una mejor idea de lo que realmente sucedió. Según ella, era racista además de violenta.
Just take me into what you saw. What was
Earlier today, my son, I and my husband were going in my car. Mm-hmm. So we're gonna go to the store to go to groceries. A boy went upstairs. The boy that was assaulted went upstairs because she was talking to them while they were fighting. They were talking, I think, a verbal discussion. He went upstairs and she said, you better not come into my house. Mm-hmm. She choked him up.
So was he, did he ever go into the house?
He stepped right here to the doorstep.
So he was standing there?
Yeah.
Were they just arguing back and
forth? Arguing back and forth.
Okay.
And then she pushed him in the process of pushing him. She's like, you better not started just doing disrespectful racial slurs and calling him a and so is your brother and started basically choking him right here.
Do you remember what hand?
Right hand.
Her right hand?
Yes, sir.
So she grabbed him by his neck.
Mm-hmm.
Did she back him up?
She backed him against this little corner wall right here.
Against the corner?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And then was she hitting him at all?
She was choking him, and then my son and I went upstairs to release him from her, and she started to harass us and said, you don't want to mess with us. We're just trying to take the child. We told the child, go home with your parents.
Yeah.
This lady's crazy. Don't even bother her. Just go home. She didn't even bother her.
Mm-hmm.
And she's like, yeah, but he started talking about my parents. Don't listen to this lady. He's crazy.
Yeah.
And from there, she kept talking crap with the neighbor downstairs. I don't know if that's her daughter. I don't know if they're related or not.
Mm-hmm.
And she started disrespecting them, disrespecting me.
Was she hitting him at all?
Yes.
She was...
Okay. Yes.
You know
she scratched him here. And then him trying to take her off him, he did hit her.
When he was trying to push her off of
him? Push her off her.
Yeah.
And then he did kick her to try to get her off her. And
right.
then we came, she tried to do the same to my son and I. I'm like, listen, you don't want to mess with us. We're just trying to get this child and get out of the way.
Okay.
Get out of the way.
Como no había ninguna evidencia concreta de agresión, María fue solo acusada de resistirse al arresto. Se declaró culpable y fue sentenciada a 24 meses de libertad condicional. El vecino de nuestro siguiente caso fue acusado de causar estragos en la carretera y en casa. Melissa Mary Hew. El 5 de febrero de 2023, agentes de Montpellier, Vermont, fueron enviados a un complejo de apartamentos después de que un residente atropellara su vehículo contra un pilar en el Porsche delantero de la casa de su vecino. Cuando el oficial llegó y examinó el vehículo, determinó que el complejo de apartamentos no era el único lugar al que ella condujo. Con base en el daño en la parte delantera del vehículo, el sospechoso concluyó que probablemente chocó contra una barandilla y posiblemente contra otro vehículo. Veamos qué descubrió su investigación.
Camera recording started.
That's what I'm trying to figure out.
Okay.
I'm pretty sure you guys are trying to figure all of that out too.
Yes, we are.
Sheriff's Department. Yeah, there you go. Close your blinds.
Yeah, I'll deal with him if you...
No. I'm pretty sure it's Sheriff's Department. You guys have already...
Yeah,
that.
No, I know, but if he starts creating a mess while we're here doing this.
Cuando llegaron los oficiales, se enteraron de que el auto era conducido por una mujer llamada Melissa. Su novio, Jeff, los recibió afuera e inmediatamente la culpó a ella, pero luego comenzó a jugar sugiriendo que tal vez podría localizarla si quisiera. Los oficiales no vieron el mismo humor en la situación que Jeff. Tampoco apreciaron que intentara quitar una cámara de vigilancia antes de que llegaran los agentes.
So, Jeff, who's driving the car?
Not myself, I can tell you that.
Okay. Who can you tell us was driving the car?
That would be Melissa's car.
Okay.
She was just out here. Where'd she go?
Probably away from you guys. I can probably try to find her.
Yeah, she needs to come out and have a chat with us.
Yeah.
Because she's driving.
It looks, from the looks of that, like she looked like she hit somebody.
And a guardrail.
So she didn't hit any people, right?
Not that we've been told yet.
Yeah. I mean, we're just starting to get calls coming in about this car hitting stuff.
Yeah.
What do you have behind your back, Jeff?
Oh, no, sorry. It's my, my cam for this idiot egging my car on the constant.
Okay. And you had this up while she...
I just took it off now because she was chirping at me and I wanted to check because it's been like 3 weeks since I actually checked the video on it.
Okay.
I just keep that up in the post so he doesn't egg my car. You guys have heard about the eggings.
Yep, we've heard about the eggings. Egger. Okay. So where was this, where'd you have this, Jeff?
I've always had this on that post.
On that post right there?
Yeah.
Okay. So do you mind if I take the SIM card? Because I'm assuming I'm going to see Melissa driving in.
No, I don't want to give it to you.
So there's a couple different ways we can do this. Okay? Let me be...
I know how it all goes. Okay. And nothing looks good as far as me saying you can't have it.
Okay.
But I think that as far as... She's either way.
I don't know
what this everything here entails.
Okay, so Jeff, there's...
But I can tell you this, that thing's not even set for recording.
Okay.
It's literally just there for him to stop egging my car.
Okay, so let me explain.
You
what...
need permission for me to have that thing.
I can do it that way, and we can do a written consent, and we just bring it back to the PD, we download the SIM card, we bring it back to you, okay? Or... Another way of doing it, I can apply for a search warrant. I'm going to seize it. I seize the whole unit.
Yeah, I think you're going to get it either way.
Okay.
But I think I'd rather make you do the hard work. Just for her benefit.
Okay. Jeff, it's not hard work for me.
I know it's
15 minutes of typing, and I put it in front of a judge tomorrow morning.
Después de que Jeff contó su historia, llegó el momento de conocer a Melissa. Con suerte, por su bien, tuvo tiempo suficiente para crear su propia historia. No tuvo un buen comienzo cuando admitió haber bebido vodka.
Melissa. Don't look at me.
Wait, what are you talking about?
Your car.
It's our car.
Oh, I don't know.
You don't know what happened to your car?
No. Okay. I worked and I came home.
Okay. About how long ago did you come home?
Hour and a half ago.
About an hour and a half ago? Okay. So, you have anything to drink since you came home?
Not
since you came home. Okay. So, Melissa, we have video of you coming home.
Okay.
About 13, 14, probably about 20 minutes ago now. Okay. I can smell the alcohol coming off you. Okay. So, how much have you had to drink today?
Couple drinks.
Yeah. Like, couple being two, couple being 12.
Two.
About two drinks. Okay. What were they?
Vodka cranberries?
Okay,
so those, yeah.
Okay. Where'd you have those at?
At my bar.
At your bar? Yeah. Where do you work?
Langdon
Street?
Yeah.
Okay. About when did you have those?
When I got off work.
When you got off work? About when was that?
2:33.
2:33? Do you know what time it is right now?
No.
Okay. I have 5 o'clock right now.
Awesome.
Okay. So where were you between 2:33 and 5 o'clock?
Oh, God damn, I didn't do anything.
You hit several things, Melissa, with your car while driving. Okay?
Okay.
Okay. Are you willing to take a PBT? You can say no, that's fine. It's not admissible in court, it's just another tool that we use. Ready? Deep breath in. Okay. Thank you very much. Melissa, do you know what the legal limit in the state of Vermont is?
19.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
18,800.
Como era de esperar, no pasó las pruebas de sobriedad y los agentes la arrestaron. Intentaron calmarla explicándole que podría regresar a casa un poco más tarde, pero no pudo controlarse.
What's that? Melissa, do you have anything in your pockets?
No.
No, I don't. Okay, so we're just gonna, I'm gonna put the handcuffs, because you have back injury, I'm gonna put the handcuffs in front of you. Okay, do you, are you gonna behave with us?
Yes.
Okay, okay. You have nothing on your person? Cell phone, anything like that?
No.
Okay. It's gonna be okay. What's that? You're gonna get home. You're gonna get home. You're gonna get home. Yep. We're gonna bring you down to the station to do some paperwork.
Please,
that's
don't.
It. Okay.
Okay. You know
we're gonna. I know. We're gonna put these on.
Yep. It's fine. You know him. He knows me.
He knows you. Yeah. Okay.
It's gonna be fine.
Corporal Michaud knows everybody. I think.
He does.
Here, I'm just gonna pull your jacket up just a little bit.
I'm so scared.
No reason to be scared.
I'm so scared.
How those feel is going to have her come over and do a surge.
Yep. All right, Leslie, I'm just going to...
No. Oh, my God. What's up?
Melissa, de 47 años, fue acusada de conducir bajo los efectos del alcohol. Nuestro siguiente caso es el clásico cebo y cambio. La persona que llamó afirmó ser la víctima, pero la policía no pudo comprar la historia que estaba vendiendo. Mujer de 37 años. El 30 de abril de 2022, en XX, el despacho policial recibió una llamada de una mujer afirmando que un hombre desnudo intentaba irrumpir en su casa. Cuando los oficiales llegaron al lugar y escucharon la historia de la persona que llamó, no cuadraba. Pronto descubrieron que ella hizo la llamada para protegerse de un cargo criminal y la escena tomó un giro violento. El presunto sospechoso fue el primero en hablar con los oficiales y estaba claro que la persona que llamó tenía sus propios objetivos y no era protegerse de un intruso desnudo. Parecía como si ella fuera la que estaba causando el disturbio.
How you doing, man?
Yeah. I guess you called the cops upstairs.
Yeah, okay. I'm just waiting for her to come out.
Okay. Well, we have to call. We call them all the time.
Yeah.
Because they're always up there fighting, Reagan. So I went up there because I'm down here with the kids and stuff.
Yeah.
And the kids are trying to sleep.
Okay.
So I went up there.
And you don't got to yell at me.
I'm not yelling at you. Hey, please. Hey. She said I broke it. Go look at her door. Go look at her door. You see, she said I broke into her house. All I did though, sir. All I did, I went up there. I knocked on the door. I banged on the door.
Stop interrupting him.
So this is what I did, sir. Because I got a witness. We both went up there. We knocked on the door because they arguing, throwing, breaking.
Yeah.
If you go upstairs into the apartment, you will see that it's trash from them to break and stuff. So, my fault. I mean, I ain't.
No, you're fine.
So, I knocked on the door. When I banged on the door opens.
Mm-hmm.
She's sitting there cussing us out. I never stepped foot in the house or none of that.
Okay.
I stood out on the little steps thing.
Where's your witness? Can you have her come out and I can talk to her? Maybe we can
it's a dude.
Oh, okay. Maybe we can resolve this for you.
Oh, okay. This is the...
Look, you got like 2 seconds with me. Look, it's cold out.
What happened?
So listen, they're arguing. Whatever the crackhead is. Constantly. Going. If you go up there right now, you see all the evidence is literally in the kitchen.
So what happened when you guys went up there?
All we did is went up there, we knocked, all we did is kept talking, kept asking them, you know, quiet the hell.
Yeah.
You know, we got keys down here. So
right.
The door was unlocked. We opened the door. She wanted to continuously kept saying, shut up. I will shoot you. I will stab you. That's literally all she kept saying. Yeah. I will shoot you. I'll get some people up here to shoot you. I'll get some people up here.
All right, we'll finish your shower.
So,
can't police open the door?
You're very mean, and I don't like it.
Come outside and talk to us.
Why?
Because I need to know what's going on.
Come on. Listen to me before listening to him.
Come outside and talk to us. Come on. No, it's disgusting in here. Let's go outside. What?
Where are my dogs? You see 3 dogs out there? A white one, a brown one,
no.
And a black one?
Come outside and talk to us.
Oh, yeah, I'm busy right now.
Come outside and talk to us.
I need to be told what to do, okay?
Well, I'm telling you what to do. Okay, then come here. Come here. No, come here. You're going to jail. Come here. Turn, put your hands behind your back. Come here.
No.
Como los agentes tuvieron que localizar a la mujer, no estaban de humor para tonterías y lo dejaron muy claro cuando le apuntaron con una taser.
Turn around. We're on the outside of the apartment. She's not cooperating. Turn around!
No, I'm not. I'm talking. Get off of me.
Stop fighting them. Stop fighting them.
Stupid ass mutt.
I got one arm. Get the other one.
God damn it. Get off me! Get off of me!
Fighting with one.
Get off me! Get off me! Get
Stop it!
Put your hands behind your back now!
Put your hands behind your back! Do it right now! Put your hand behind your back, stop. Stop her.
Stop!
Stop.
Dumbass. Yes. Yes. Stop. Get up. Do it again, you dummy. Bitch. I'm going to turn you. Sorry, fuck ass. You goddamn fucking dumbass. I had to let me go. Now. Squirt, go home. God damn it. Go home. Off me. Idiot. You're stupid. That's all you're bad, bitch.
La ira del sospechoso solo incriminaría más cargos en el camino de ida a la comisaría. En ese momento el caballo ya se encontraba fuera del establo.
Good job. Let's go this way.
Oh no, that's not a good job. Now we're in jail. I'm sorry. I've been up for a couple of days.
What?
I said I've been up.
When was the last time you smoked meth?
I don't know. Why? What's the matter?
Because I think you're high on meth.
No, I'm irritated because I got mental issues and the difference. I'm trying to get you. I'm trying to get you. I'm trying to get you. I'm trying to get you.
Have a seat. Take some breath.
El sospechoso de 37 años fue acusado de agresión y resistirse al arresto. A continuación, dos vecinos intentan resolver sus diferencias enfrentándose en un estacionamiento. Veamos cómo le funcionó. Raekwon. El 28 de febrero de 2023, en Dayton, Ohio, los agentes respondieron a una pelea reportada en el estacionamiento de un complejo de apartamentos. La pelea supuestamente se desató tras un desacuerdo entre vecinos. Cuando llegaran los oficiales, tendrían que hablar con ambas partes antes de poder llegar a una conclusión sobre lo que realmente estaba sucediendo. Los sospechosos estaban parados en el estacionamiento, amplificados y listos cuando llegaron los agentes del orden. Afirmaron que su vecino chocó su coche con niños dentro y por tanto fueron las víctimas, pero ¿era creíble la historia?
This lady right here just damaged my car.
No,
damaged my car. She just did this to my
She's
car.
She's a liar.
Can you go inside your house, please?
Yes, sir,
yes, thank you. Because I called earlier. All
right.
I'm being threatened. Okay. I'm only 24 years old. She's grown. Real grown. I'm young.
And yes, she called.
That's a witness over there. A witness.
She's not been kicking my sister's car. With her car, everything. My sister got f***ing lupus.
I called her and I just came back home. I got out of the car. Another girl, they pulled off now. Tell me, what's up? What's up?
Trying to say my sister got your sister to your car, but you don't have no proof my sister did to your car.
No.
So why would you, my sister don't do like that. Why would you even do something to her car?
So
you did it in front of her. So
you
tried my sister.
I got lupus. I'm weak as f***. Da da da. Okay, I got lupus. That's why they be at me. Cause they think I'm weak and I'm young. Like you keep f***ing with me. What's the problem? Why you keep f***ing with me? Then you say, hey, that s***. Like leave me. That's the witness over there. End of that window.
What'd you call for earlier?
Because
same
she hit
thing.
My car.
She
hit my car, sir.
Her.
She hit my car while I was
here.
Me and my son.
With her car?
yes. with her truck.
All right.
And so, you see the dent.
So that happened earlier.
And then when I just got out of the car again, she walked up her and a fat girl jumped out of the car.
To my, what's up? What you want
to
do?
I went to the rent office and everything. This is how I feel up there. He's talking about evicting both of us. When she, they're messing with me, sir. They're messing with me. I just got my car.
Uno de los acusados, identificado como Raekwon, tuvo la oportunidad de contar la historia de hombre a hombre con el oficial. Su intento de exonerarse de las malas acciones fracasó estrepitosamente y sus familiares no lo ayudaron.
So, she bumped into the car as she was driving away.
No, like,
left.
Okay, when we get the first time I went here, she came to pick me up for it. I just had got back.
Okay,
so as we were getting out of the car, she like,
She hit the car with her car.
I wasn't here when that happened.
I understand.
Okay, so after we hopped out the car, she kicked it, and then she tried to run up on my sister. I hopped in front, and she tried to say I hit her. I just
did anything. Kayshawn, did anything happen? Did anything happen when she bumped into your car? I mean, was words exchanged at all?
Okay, this is what happened when she bumped on my car. I called the police. I didn't say no words. I went to the office. So when I came back, she was walking up to me. After everything on die-die, I blew a horn.
Yeah, she was blowing the horn to let her know.
So that had no intention.
She did it.
She was moving it. My son was in it. Zyla, come over here. She lied. They lied. They hate on me, sir. So they want me to file. That's why I told Mr. Beeman. They want you to evict me because they hate on me. Yeah, they want me to get in trouble because they hate on me. That's why I called my sisters. They don't be knowing I got nobody because we don't like getting in trouble. They don't know I got nobody. I guess they try to bully me because they feel like I got lupus and I'm weak. Like she just said, you got lupus and you weak. She just said it up there. You ain't here.
Unos minutos más tarde llega el momento de escuchar a la presunta víctima, quien contó una historia muy diferente y más creíble. La historia de Raekwon quedó expuesta y cualquier plan que tendría para él tendría que ser reprogramado.
You got video?
Yeah, I got video, sir. She hit my car. This man really did physically assault me. Look at my face. Look at this side, and then look at this side. He hit me,
okay.
And I got witnesses.
Okay.
I recorded them after they hit my car. You look in her car right now. There's a black shower rod. They physically tried to hit me with it, and that's how she busted out my window.
Okay, and he punched you?
He punched me. What happened was, she accused me of hitting her car. I did not hit her car. I had a whole witness in the car with me. There's no music blasting. So if I hit your car, you feel me, I would have heard it. I didn't hit her car. I go about my day. I come back and I've been called by the apartment manager that I'm going to be evicted because I hit somebody's car. And I'm like, what are you talking about? So she pulls back up and was like, and I was like, where did I hit your car at? Where did I hit your car? And she points it out and it's scratched. If you look on her car, there's scratch marks. And I'm like, if I hit your car, my car is gold. So there would be black on my car or at least gold on your car. There's no dent, there's no scratches, no nothing. What they're saying, it doesn't make sense because my car sits higher than...
I got you.
You feel me?
All
and
right.
So then I was like, they
so you called, kicked the back of her car.
He kicked my car. The man who assaulted me, that man right there, kicked the back of my car. He said, you want to mess with my sister, mess with me. So he kicked my car. So I kicked the back of her car. And that's when he punched me in my face.
When did he hit the window with the shower rod? Or was it him?
It was her right there in the black. Her right there hit my car. And she was right there, witness it.
Okay. So he punched you one time?
Yes, he did. He punched me, bam, right in the face.
Okay.
And I said I was calling the police.
Were you walking up on him?
No. I wasn't walking up on him. He came and met me halfway. I was sitting on a car that was back there, and he was in the parking lot. And he was like, you hit my sister, I got something for you. He's just going off. And I'm like, I didn't hit your sister's car, and I'm trying to rationalize, but you can't rationalize with irrational. So I'm like, whatever. He was like, since you hit my sister's car, I'm going to hit your car. He kicked my car. I can show you where the dent is. And then so I kicked their car. You're not about to kick my car and think I'm not going to do anything. And that's when he physically assaulted me.
Mallory, we got to take you to jail for assault. Okay?
I didn't hit her, though.
A lot of people said you did.
Then she wasn't even at the lady that how she at. She went at the door, sir.
Put your hand
behind
your
back. Don't worry about it. You'll get out.
There you go.
You'll get out.
Here. I never landed. I don't want that, bro.
Raekwon fue acusado de agresión. En nuestro siguiente caso conocerán a una mujer que decidió tomarse un par de cócteles y volver a pintar el garage de su vecino, aunque se olvidó de decírselo. Finalmente consiguió un Epiphone y parecía recordar haber destrozado el garage de su vecino. Pintura en aerosol en el garaje. En Albuquerque, Nuevo México, el 12 de abril de 2021 se enviaron agentes al lugar de un reporte de vandalismo. Una mujer fue acusada de pintar con aerosol el garage de su vecino después de una disputa sobre las tarifas de la asociación de propietarios. Las víctimas le dijeron al oficial que la mujer estaba borracha y la vieron destrozar su propiedad. Parecía un caso abierto y cerrado, excepto que el sospechoso se escapó y no la encontraron por ningún lado. ¿Podrán los agentes, con la ayuda de sus vecinos, localizarla? Vamos a averiguar.
Hi there.
Hi, hey John.
Doing all right?
She's hammered drunk.
Okay, is anybody hurt?
No. Nobody's hurt, but she...
So, she was on a call, and I was in the bedroom.
So, where does she live, right here?
No, but she ran in there.
Okay.
She ran, knocked on the door, and they let her in, and they're hiding her. They keep opening, like, the door and peeping out to see.
Has anything like this ever happened before?
No.
No.
Do you know her?
No.
We've never seen her in here before.
She's a realtor, she said, that lives on the other side. And so she says we're white trash.
She said we're white trash, we have stuff in our yard. And so, I mean,
gotcha.
She barricaded our front walkway. She spray painted our door. So I was sitting in the bedroom. My son was on the couch and we heard a knock on the door and we thought it was him coming home. My son went to look out the peephole and I said, did you unlock it? He said, no, it's all red. So we thought he was holding something. We opened the door and saw the spray paint came out here. And then I was over there talking to this neighbor in the van because he's got a Ring camera. And we saw this neighbor come out for a bike ride, but didn't see anybody here. And she comes walking by and, what happened? I was out walking my dog and she's carrying a can of spray paint in it.
And her hand is completely red. I got her on video, so she's in there trying to wash her hands and stuff.
And so then she ran over to them and she knows them and she's like, Joe, that's the guy that lives there. And I forgot what name he called her and told her, calm down. And so now he's keeping her in there and my other son's watching the back to make sure she doesn't try to get out of the backyard.
Gotcha. Give us just a moment. That video footage, are you able to show that to me? Is it on your phone?
Yeah.
Okay. Let me take a look at that. And let's all go over here and go over to this house just in case she decides she wants to come out and start something.
I think it's supposed to say white trash, and then I don't know what the bottom, because she kept calling him white trash.
Cuando llegó el oficial, la persona que llamó lo encontró en la calle y pudo darle detalles específicos sobre el vandalismo. Los hechos les parecían claros y solo quedaba localizar al sospechoso y los denunciantes estuvieron más que felices de ayudar.
Hello, police department.
Police department.
Can we come inside?
Yeah, sure.
Is that okay? Thank you.
Hi, ma'am. How are you? Good, how are you?
This is Lisha.
George 532 PD, we're going to be in the residence of 252. If you could update both units, we're going to be with the subject.
I'm sorry, what is your name? Alicia? Okay. Okay, Alicia, can you go ahead and stand up and come outside with us for a second, please?
Yeah, we got something to talk to you about.
What do I need to talk about?
Yeah. And we'll talk to you in just a moment, sir.
Yeah, we'll
you having trouble walking, ma'am?
Yeah, I drank.
Okay.
She's a little bit.
I drank.
Okay, I got her. Okay. I got her from here.
All right.
We'll help you out, okay? Don't push me, ma'am.
Hi there. I would
Let's
love.
Step outside, okay?
Gene.
Just follow
Let's step
him.
Outside.
No, I will.
Ma'am, we're the police and you are being recorded on our cameras, okay? Just so you know.
I love it. Oh, wait. We need to go outside.
Yeah, let's go ahead and step outside, okay?
Yeah. I've been drinking.
Yep.
I haven't in a year.
Okay. Okay.
Joe.
We'll talk to you in just a moment.
Joe, what's going on?
Yeah, you need to listen to us, okay? We are the police, okay? And right now you are being detained, okay? You are not free to leave. We are going to place you in handcuffs, okay? So you need to put your hands behind your back. Don't fight us or anything. Everything's being recorded on our cameras, okay?
That's fine.
One second, okay?
Okay?
Okay. All right. I can tell you've been drinking tonight, and you said yourself you've been drinking, and that's not a crime. So how much have you been drinking tonight?
I had like three drinks.
Three drinks
of what? I'm in a recovery.
Okay.
And I was trying to test everything.
You were trying to test what? The alcohol?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, what kind of alcohol was it?
I don't know,
Was it like hard liquor, beer, wine?
Yeah, hard liquor probably.
Okay.
Yeah.
You said you had three drinks?
Yeah, and I would love, take me away.
Okay, so let me ask you, what happened tonight? And start from the beginning. So
you were drinking, and then what happened? I am so tired.
Okay.
He always has shit, and I'm a realtor.
Okay.
And yeah, I'm like slurring my words.
Well, you've been drinking a lot, right?
Eso facilitó las cosas a los agentes que la arrestaron, pero pronto olvidó nuevamente que estaba siendo arrestada. Una noche en la cárcel le vendría bien.
All right, we're here. Watch your step.
Oh.
You gotta step up.
Step up. Okay. I know. I drank.
Uh-huh. Come on.
Yep. Good drink. Okay, hold on a minute.
I don't want you falling back into the car.
No, I don't want to either. And I know.
Oh.
I know. I drank.
Stand still for just a second, okay?
It's fine. I drink.
Here, okay? Let's go this way.
Take a seat
right
it.
There, okay?
Where here?
Right here.
I love it. Why?
Okay.
Why? Are you...
Just stay right here, okay?
No, I want to know why am I...
Okay, if you get up, I'm going to have to handcuff... Oh!
You already handcuffed me.
Okay. Are you going to be able to sit down or...
No. What? Why are you handcuffing me?
Because you're under arrest. I've already told you.
I'm under arrest. I love it.
La mujer fue acusada de vandalismo. Ella era una aficionada en comparación con el sospechoso de nuestro sexto caso, que condujo por el césped de su vecino y estuvo a punto de llegar a su casa. Stephanie, el 22 de enero de 2023, los agentes respondieron a una llamada al 911 de un propietario preocupado después de que el automóvil de un vecino se deslizara por el césped rompiendo el proceso y se detuvo después de golpear su casa. Los funcionarios encargados de hacer cumplir la ley estaban muy ansiosos por escuchar la historia de la víctima cuando llegaron y estaban en alerta máxima esperando encontrar resistencia por parte del sospechoso, ya que tuvieron que asumir que el alcohol fue un factor importante en el accidente. Así es como se desarrolló.
Stay in your car. Get on the ground. Is there anybody else in the car?
No.
6-2, I've got her at gunpoint. We're in front of 2299 Samira. 2299 Samira. She's on the floor. All right, go ahead and get up. Slowly get up.
No, thank you.
I'm giving you a direct order to get up off the ground and face away from me right now.
Absolutely, sir.
Turn around. Put your hands on top of your head. Walk back towards the sound of my voice. Put your hands on top of your head and walk back towards the sound of my voice. Keep going. Keep going. Keep going. Keep going. You're doing just fine. Keep going. Hey, get back in the house. Hey, come face us. Keep walking back towards us. Sir, get inside. We'll come talk to you in a second, please. Keep walking back towards us.
Walk backwards.
Walk backwards.
Face away.
Turn around and walk backwards. Keep going.
Face away.
I have nothing.
Okay.
Yes,
turn around.
I have nothing.
Turn around.
Please don't aggressively.
If you don't want to listen to our orders, then...
I do. I'm sorry. I want to listen to our orders. How are you doing?
Not too bad. So what part of your house did she hit?
Right there.
Okay. So did you guys hear it happen, or... Did
our bedroom's right there.
Okay.
So it shook the bedroom.
Woke you up. All right.
Yeah.
And then I'm assuming you came downstairs. What all did you see?
Saw the car sitting here. Next thing I know, she's revving it. I'm on the phone with 911.
Mm-hmm.
And he comes outside.
he's telling her to stay put. Mm-hmm. But she backs up right here. And then next thing I know, he's like, she's leaving, she's leaving. Mm-hmm. She goes out that way and by the pine, on the other side of the pine tree there.
Okay. Like right in between the, that box right there on the tree.
Los agentes encontraron un bono cuando registraron el vehículo del sospechoso, marihuana y parafernalia. Agrega el hecho de que ella estaba de camino a casa desde el bar y el conductor no tenía una pierna sobre la cual pararse. Incluso después del caos, el vecino estaba preocupado por el bienestar del conductor.
I got hit by a drunk driver last night in my truck.
Well, well. So.
Wow.
Yeah. So it's gonna end up getting towed.
Copy, thanks.
They will.
Okay, I would say it'll be kind of hard to
chip. She's off on it,
actually. 3:30 in the morning.
Yeah, I don't know how she ended up. She said she was at the bar, right?
Yeah, she said she was at a bar in Kent.
In Kent.
Yeah. Well, tough thing, man.
The part is I got two young kids.
PJ's going to the house.
Okay, cool.
Yeah.
All right, so if we need anything, we'll let you know, but there's going to be a tow truck here.
Hoping that. At first thing I thought, I was like, what the hell? Cookies. Just cookies.
Yeah, it's the animal cookies.
It smell pretty good.
El sospechoso, que no estaba manejando bien la situación, y todas las sustancias de su organismo estaban causando estragos en su estado emocional.
All right, I'm going to have you get out, okay?
My truck first, please.
It'll be easier if you get out, and then I'll pull it up.
Absolutely.
We're in our garage, so it's warm.
Don't have much room.
It's up pocket, up.
Can you pull it down to the nurse?
Okay, lift up your tongue. Open your mouth, lift up your tongue. Start over. Okay, open up your mouth, lift up your tongue. Perfect. Alright, you can put the boots back on. Okay, you're good.
Your light's on. Remember, just a steady blow, okay? Ready?
De hecho, le preguntó a un oficial si podía caminar a casa, y la idea fue rápidamente descartada.
There's your belt. If you want to put that stuff down, you can put your belt on. I'm going to hold on to this for a second because there is a little knife on here until I drop you off. Okay.
You're just walking.
You're not walking home. You're not walking home.
No.
Not in the condition you are in right now. If I drop you off at home and catch you walking outside, I'm going to arrest you again
for
public intox. You can't be walking around when you're drunk. You're clearly drunk, okay? We didn't get a good sample on there, but you were double the legal limit, okay? So you're hammered. You're not going walking around.
La mujer, identificada como Stephanie, fue acusada de conducir bajo los efectos del alcohol, posesión de marihuana y de parafernalia de drogas, y de tener un contenedor abierto. En el siguiente caso les presentaremos a uno de los compañeros de cuarto más fuera de control que jamás hayan visto, que decidió perturbar a un vecindario entero. Jody. El 2 de noviembre de 2023, la central policial recibió una llamada de una mujer afirmando que su compañera de cuarto estaba actuando de manera errática y que estaba preocupada por su bienestar. Cuando llegaron las fuerzas del orden, su discusión en curso se pudo escuchar afuera y el nivel de preocupación de los oficiales aumentó rápidamente. Después de hablar con el sospechoso, la situación aumentó aún más.
I never said a single word. I never said to calm down. I'm trying to figure out what's going on before
I... It's 911! Get in there!
There's no immediate emergency.
How do you know?
He's sitting on the bed.
Yeah. Oh, my God. I swear to God, I've already got a lawsuit. The last cop that was here got me upset, and I was supposed to calm down. Go in there, and you'll know why I'm...
Why am I here?
Because I called 911 and I said, bring an ambulance, he needs medical care.
So an ambulance, so this isn't a law enforcement issue.
Hey, stay right here.
It's my house. Don't you order me around. You won't take my order. You guys are getting sued like. My attorneys are already on it. I have under my arm, sir. I
have... Ma'am.
Am I going to get arrested for battery on the Leo? Because that's... I'm not touching nobody. And I need you to move. I need you to move so I don't hit you. Back up. It's my house. Back up.
Are you threatening me?
Yeah, I am. Yeah, I'm threatening. Oh, my God. If you are... Oh, my God.
Relax. Relax.
Oh, my God.
You're being placed under arrest. Stop. Stop resisting.
Oh, my God.
Assault on a law enforcement officer. You made a credible threat that you're going to do harm to a law enforcement officer.
You know that means the threat. Oh, my God.
He's physically handcapped. I don't believe he can.
Okay. Okay. I need to be arrested.
Yep.
I served him with legal papers. I have a caseworker on it. I have a caseworker on it. Don't go in my home. You're not allowed in my home, or you will be arrested for entering my home without a search warrant.
Get inside.
That's really gonna f*** up.
Put your leg up.
I'm gonna put my leg up. I'm not gonna resist. I'm gonna show everybody how psychotic I am. Yeah. Yeah.
Después de que aseguraran a la loca, el oficial habló con su vecino y pudo aclarar un poco más la situación, pintando un panorama más general de todo lo que había sucedido. La mujer confirmó la historia con sus locos desvaríos durante todo el camino hacia la comisaría.
Who is she to you? Just a neighbor? What is she, what did she bang on your door for?
Door, window. I don't know. She's been over to my house about 4 times today.
Okay. Who's kindy to her?
This guy?
Yeah.
Money. Tenant.
So he brings in, so he, okay, so he just lives there.
Yeah, he lives there. And pays good money to live there.
Okay.
All right. They've been there about 3 years. And,
is this recent that she's been doing this?
It's been going on for, I mean, like 6 months.
Okay. Is he physically handicapped, mentally handicapped, bit of both?
Old, lazy, won't
okay.
get around.
Okay.
She's been...
Well, I only ask because he's laying on pee pads, so like...
Yeah, bladder control. Yeah.
No, I understand that.
Yeah. No, but he wheelchairs around. The other day he was over here in his little sit-down wheelchair thing. Yeah. Mentally he's there. Physically he needs some help.
Okay.
That's what she's supposed to be doing. I don't know what the hell's going on with her. Well, she's always been like this for 8 years.
I think I'm very confident somebody just had a $210,000 house destroyed from a man that I've done nothing but cater to, cook, clean. I literally have been up all day washing about 20 towels 3 times each. And I had to do it right away because it was full of his feces. That he all over my $1,000 mattress. But I'll be calm. Because, God, I don't want another charge.
Oh, I know.
Is your body cam right still on?
Do you have a body?
Officer, is your body cam still on?
Oh, Bert, okay.
I'm requesting that your body cam on.
It's on.
Or you don't have to do that.
It's looking straight at you.
Fue acusada de proferir amenazas con la intención de generar un daño corporal y también resistirse al arresto.